Hi friend, welcome to Zio Entire. So today we are going to discuss one more important topic which is related to the petrology. So petrology is nothing but the study of rocks, and in this lesson we are going to discuss the most abundant rock which is found on the earth, that is the granite. The granite word is derived from the Latin, which means that the rock is composed of grains. So this is a simple regarding the granites. So particularly granites are the intrusive rocks because grain size is coarser. When magma is going to crystallization, the crystallization takes more time. So that's why the grain size is coarse. So this is the simple phenomenon behind these granites. So in this lesson we are going to discuss five most important aspects which is related to the granites. So first one, we are going to discuss in this lesson, what is the composition of the granites? What are the minerals which are present in the granites? And what type of textures which are present in the granite? So that aspect we are going to discuss in more detail in this lesson. Then second aspect we are going to discuss, that is classification of granites. You see, there are different types of classification on the basis of the mineral composition, on the basis of the emplacement of the particular granites, on the basis of the genetic classification of the granites, and these types of classification we are going to discuss in this particular lessons. So next aspect, that is the third one, that is the geochemistry of the granites. So in geochemistry we are going to discuss what are the elements, particularly major elements, rare earth elements and trace elements which are present in the granites. So that also we are going to discuss in more detail, particularly in this lesson. Then next aspect, that is the petrogenesis. Petrogenesis means how granite is originated, what are the phenomenon, what is the process behind that. So that aspect we are also going to discuss in this particular lesson. Then next aspect, that is the last one, that is the tectonic regimes. What are the tectonic regimes where granites are mostly found or mostly abundant, and what is the reason behind that? So these aspects we are going to discuss in more detail regarding these granites. First one is the composition, then second one the classification, then third one is the geochemistry of the granites, fourth one is the petrogenesis, and last that is the tectonic regimes. So these five aspects we are going to discuss in more detail. So let's we start the lesson. So as we know that granite is a igneous rocks, so it is a product of the magma, and magma is nothing but the hot molten material of the rock. You can see there are different types of colors of the granites. You can see granite in white color, you can see granite in pink color, you can see granite in gray color also. This is because of the composition of the granites. So when we see the granite having different minerals. So rock is nothing but the aggregation of the minerals, and particularly this granite is having principal minerals like feldspar, quartz, hornblende, micas. So these are the principal minerals which are present in the granites. Granite having different textures also. You can see there are massive granites. There are generally these massive granites are hypidiomorphic, granular in nature. Granites sometimes also show porphyritic textures, in which mostly these phenocrysts, they are made up of feldspar, sometimes quartz, sometimes hornblende, etc. Again, some granites shows some intergrowth textures. Two or more minerals, they are intergrowth to each other. So they may be myrmecite, they may be graphic type of granites, or sometimes you can see, so there are perthite types of textures which are also found in these particular granites. For the normative calculations for the research, so usually 90% quartz, K feldspar and plagioclase, these three important minerals consider for the normative calculations. Then next one is the classification of granites. So based on alkali feldspar plagioclase ratio, so these granites are classified into five categories. When a rock or a granite is composed of alkali feldspar, or in which the granites in which alkali feldspar is 100% and plagioclase is 0%, then those rocks are called as alkali granites. Then if granite shows 90% alkali feldspar and 10% plagioclase, it means that that rock is called as feldspar granites. Then if rock is composed of 65% alkali feldspar and 35% plagioclase, then that granite is called as adimelite. If granite shows 35% alkali feldspar and 65% that is the plagioclase, then that rock is called as granodiorite. If alkali feldspar in granites in between 10 to 0% and plagioclase 90 to 100%, then that rock is called as tonalite. And these are the varieties of granites. These are the types of these particular granites. Then second classification, that is based on the emplacement level, that is the catazone, mesozone and epizone. Catazone are deep granites, mesozone are intermediate granites, and epizone are the shallow granites. On the basis of this emplacement level, these granites are classified into three types, that is the catazone, mesozone and epizone. So when we see the catazone granites, so these granites are generally found mostly where deeply eroded terrains are there, and generally they are having concordant margins. We know that concordant and disconcordant in the igneous forms of the igneous body we have already discussed. You see my earlier video, so you will get all the information regarding the what is concordant. So particularly these granites are having concordant margins and they show strong foliation. So this is the characteristic feature of this catazone granites. Then next, that is the mesozone granites, range in which magmatic and metamorphic rocks more easily we can distinguish, and they show root pendants common. So this is regarding these mesozone granites. They are formed at the intermediate emplacement level. Then last one, that is the epizone. So they are shallow granites. Within a few kilometer of the surface, we can find out such type of granites, and they are emplaced in brittle, sedimentary or volcanic rocks. So these are associated with contemporary volcanism, narrow contact metamorphic zones, and they having great economic mineral deposits. So this is regarding the classification of granites on the basis of emplacement level. Then third type of classification of granites, that is the genetic classification of granites. So these granites are I-type granites, S-type granites, A-type granites and M-type granites. So I-type granites, the source of these granites are the igneous rocks. So they are typically called as metalluminous granites. S-type granites, the source of these rocks are the sedimentary rocks. So particularly it is also called as peraluminous. Then A-type granites, so these are the anorogenic rift zone granites, typically peralkaline granites. And last one, that is the M-type granites, they are plagiogranites associated with ophiolites. We have already discussed what is the ophiolites. You see my earlier video, what are the ophiolites. And these M-type granites are generally associated with those ophiolites. Then fourth classification of the granites on the basis of the mineralogy. You see, depends on the alumina saturation, that is the peraluminous, metalluminous and peralkaline. In peraluminous, Al2O3 is greater than K2O plus Na2O plus CO, so that is called as peraluminous. Metalluminous, in which K2O plus Na2O plus CO, so these three are greater than Al2O3 is greater than Na2O plus K2O, so this is called as metalluminous. Then last one, that is the peralkaline, in which Na2O plus K2O is greater than Al2O3. So this is regarding the classification of granites on the basis of alumina saturation. Granites having compositional zoning in the granites. So what are the causes? There are particularly three causes. One is the maybe successive intrusion of more differentiated magmas. This is the one cause. Second cause, that is crystallization in form walls. Then third cause, that is the wall rock contamination. Due to these three causes, there you can find out the compositional zoning in the granites. Then geochemistry of the granites. Granites having three types of elements, that is the major element, trace elements, rare earth elements. When we see the major elements, the granites are rich in low melting components, particularly SiO2, Al2O3, Na2O and K2O, with highly variable Na2O and K2O ratios. So this is the regarding the major elements which are present in the granites. When we see the trace elements, so trace elements in the granites are very poor in compatible trace elements, such as nickel, Cr, that is the chromium, cobalt and strontium, but are highly rich in incompatible elements. So that is the including barium, rubidium, zircon, niobium, that is tantalum, that is the uranium, thorium and lead. Then rare earth elements, when we see the granites having highly variable enriched granites. When we see the Archean granites or granitoids show low enrichment of rare earth elements without LREV fractionation. But most of the granites exhibit fractionated REV patterns with negative euphorbium anomalies. So this is regarding the rare earth elements. And what are the major element, trace elements and rare earth elements? We have already discussed in my earlier videos, you see, and later on you will get all the information what are the major element, trace elements and rare earth elements. Now the next aspect, that is the petrogenesis, how the granites are formed. So there are two most important processes, and because of these two processes granites are evolved. So first one is the fractionation. Fractionations, you see, only volumetrically small granites bodies could be formed by fractionation of basaltic or andesitic magma. Fractionation in which the minerals are crystallized according to their temperature, and this is one of the most important cause behind the formation of the granites. Then second cause, that is the crustal melting. Crustal melting is a possible option for the generation of batholithic granite bodies. Australians and Britishers believe that the granites are mainly derived by the melting of the crust. When the melting of rocks taken place, particularly there are different types of rocks, and when the melting of these types of rocks are happening, then there is a formation of granites. And you see, there is a different types of S-type granites, I-type granites, A-type granites, M-type granites. You see I-type granites, in which melting of igneous, that is the meta-igneous rocks, that is the meta-aluminous, we can say that when the melting of such rocks taken place, that granites are called as I-type granites, and this is a product of crustal melting. Then S-type granites are the melting of sediments, particularly meta-aluminous, or it is also called as per-aluminous, in which you see shale, in which K2O rich melt, greywacke is melted, then that rock, particularly Na2O, rich melt, on the basis of these S-type granites are formed. Then A-type granites, in which melting or fractionation of tholitic rocks or tholites, and that is nothing but the per-alkaline, and last one is the M-type granites, and this is a product of the differentiation of basalt or melting of gabbro or contamination by the sediments, and due to which M-type granites are formed. So this is regarding the petrogenesis of these granites. Then last aspect, that is the granite, at what environment, at what tectonic regimes they are mostly abundant. First one is the island arcs. You see, island arcs are nothing but the, when two plates collide with each other, then the whatever the plates which is subducted, that get melted and that magma comes on the earth's surface and there is a formation of island arcs. And mostly these island arcs are composed of these granites. Then second tectonic regions where particularly granites are found, that is the orogenic continental margins, where when two continental plates collide with each other and that at the that particular margins we can find out the particularly granites. Then intracontinental orogenic belts. So in between the intracontinental belts we can find out particularly granites. Then intercontinental orogenic belts, it is exact opposite of this intracontinental. At that particular margin also, or at that particular belts also, you can find out particular this granite. Then anorogenic continental regions, you see, so this is again place where we can find out granites. And at last, you see there are different oceans basins. At that particular ocean basins, we can find out the granites. So this is regarding the granite rock. We have already discussed internal structure of the earth, and there are two types of crust. One is the continental crust and the second is the ocean crust. This continental crust is made up of particularly this granite, that is the silica and aluminium rich rock, that is the Sial. So this is regarding the granites. So we have discussed what are the granites, what are the different aspects which are related to the granites, particularly composition of the granites, what are the minerals present in the granites. Here we have discussed the different types of classification of granites, what is the geochemistry of these particularly granites, what are the major elements, what are the trace elements, or what are the rare earth elements which are present in the granites, what is the petrogenesis, or how the granites are evolved. That aspect we have discussed in this particular lesson, and tectonic regimes. These aspects, these five aspects, we have discussed in more detail in this particular lesson. If you like my video, share and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Geo Entire, all about the earth.